Thousands of new homes are to be built in Auckland in a bid to ease the housing crisis. The government's planned new development will be made up of 3,000 to 4,000 homes on 29 hectares of land that was formerly part of Unitec's Mount Albert campus. It's the first major development under the government's Kiwi Build program. The emphasis is on affordable homes, that's two- or three-bedroomed houses, costing up to $600,000. This report from Q&A's Corin Dan.
This sprawling campus in Auckland has plenty of surplus land, so Unitec, the government and local Māori have cut a deal to build up to 4,000 houses on the site.
This is a significant project, one of the larger of any project of its kind.
Those Mount Albert homes will be a mixture of private dwellings and state houses. However, 40% will be part of Labor's flagship Kiwi Build policy of affordable homes.
This isn't about runs on a political board. This is about providing housing that is decent and affordable for New Zealanders.
National, however, says it's smoke and mirrors.
There's nothing particularly new here. It was already on the cards, either through private developers or through government.
The Kiwi Build homes being built at Unitec will vary in size, but with a maximum price of $600,000. Not everyone, though, can buy one.
They're first home buyers or second chancers who are in the same position. They will put their name into a ballot for a particular group of houses in a particular development.
Meanwhile, on Q&A, the Housing Minister was defending claims by economists that the plan to build 10,000 Kiwi Build homes a year doesn't stack up.
I mean, Infometrics, the economic outfit, they just said, you're pulling numbers out of your ass. That's what they said. That was the name of their report. Kiwi Build, you're pulling numbers out of your ass.
I tell you what, that's a lot better than sitting on your ass for 9 years, which is what the former government did on housing.
The reaction from housing commentators, meanwhile, was mixed.
I'm actually heartened when I listen to him because the bigger picture, and which is about building more houses as quickly as possible in order to bring prices down, and that's got to be the major focus.
We can't keep going on like the way we've been doing, but there are some concerns here, particularly that question of affordability.
But if they're not in the realistic affordable range with enough bedrooms for Māori and Pacifica families, there will be an inequitable issue here.
The government won't say how much it paid for the land at Unitec other than it paid market values. The first homes are expected to be built next year. Corin Dan, One News.